exams coming closer and closer and closer. Some of you may be getting very tensed up. Some of you may be saying, it's okay, yaar, I'll deal with it. But in either case, you'll be having a lot of people who will be telling you, study hard, study hard, study more. Actually, I don't believe in that, you know. I don't think studying hard gets you results. I think studying smart gets you results. What do you mean by this thing called study smart? It means being able to know when to study. There are times when you need to study, there are times when you don't need to study. It means to know where to study. Oh my God, it makes so much difference where and how you're studying, you know that. And then comes the techniques. How to study. There are different ways of studying. What suits you should be the one that you should pick up. Once you do that, then you become selective. What to study, when. After you have mastered this, or while you are mastering it, there will be one question that you need to ask yourself, that is, why to study? Why study at all? Is it just to get that stupid extra marks? No, it's much more than that. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take you through this process of when to study, where to study, how to study, what to study, and why to study. If you understand these concepts, believe me, you'll not only do much better in your exams, you'll have true learning taking place. What goes in will remain permanently with you. Okay? Best of luck. Have you had days when you have questioned yourself, why should I study at all? Forget about whether I like maths, I hate biology and stuff like that. But why should I study at all? I hear these stories about these guys, you know, who dropped out of school or college and became multimillionaires and stuff like that. You're right, they do exist. But they are a very small minority. It's like winning a lottery ticket. You can't buy a lottery ticket and say, I don't need to earn money now because I'm going to win a lottery ticket, right? So, 99% of the people who are successful in this world, who have done something, they are people who have acquired knowledge. The first thing to remember is, when you have knowledge, your self-esteem goes up. You feel proud of yourself. Imagine yourself sitting with a group of friends and they are talking about some new app or some new gadget or some new technology that has come in. And you feel like a stupid fool, you don't know anything about it. How do you feel? On the other hand, if you have read it up, if you have experimented, if you have tried it out, don't you feel nice? The same thing will happen to you when you grow up. When you are out there in the big world and when somebody is talking something, somebody is negotiating with you, somebody is interviewing you, and you can talk very proudly and say, hey guys, I know this. There's another thing that comes to your mind. Why should I study all the subjects? I'm going to be a software engineer, why should I study biology? I'm going to be a journalist, why should I study science? I can assure you, every subject that you are studying, somewhere or the other, is going to be useful to you in life. Yes, after you come to 10th, you can start dropping subjects, you can start focusing, you can start going into whatever you feel like doing. But basically, I would like you to understand the significance that every subject will be useful to you regardless of which vocation or which profession you take up. It will also be useful to you outside your vocation. A lot of people don't realize that when you deal with outsiders, when you are purchasing something, when you are building a house, when you are negotiating for something, all the knowledge of these subjects is what comes into you. The other thing is, at this age, if you start studying and if you, make it into a habit that something new comes in, I want to learn this, I want to go ahead with that, I want to become proficient in this, it becomes a habit. When it becomes a habit, when you grow up, you will constantly be learning. You will be upgrading. You belong to a generation where change is going to be very fast. Every now and then new changes, new things are going to come up. And if you are the type of person who loves acquiring knowledge, who has that thirst for it, and who has built up that habit, you will realize that it's so easy throughout your life to keep picking up those changes. In your generation, let me also tell you, your basic education may stop by the time you are 20 or 22 or whatever it is. But there's lots to be learned later. There are going to be a lot of, you know, certification. There are going to be a lot of areas where you are going to find that you can upgrade yourself, and you will go through that smoothly. So just make learning into a habit, not for the sake of exams, not for the sake of marks, but for the sake of gaining knowledge, which will be your greatest asset lifelong.